This week on Jersey Matters, Rutgers was the first university in America to mandate that students be vaccinated. But what about the faculty? We'll talk with the man in charge of health affairs at Rutgers. New Jersey is finally going to deal with dangerous lead in water pipes, but it's going to be a long and expensive process. New Jersey allows betting on esports. Is it a way to get the young to bet? And the fencing stars of the future are training in New Jersey. Welcome to Jersey Matters. I'm Larry Menti. Recently, Rutgers University mandated all healthcare workers on campus to get vaccinated. This is after being the first university in the country to mandate that students get vaccinated. But why no mandate for faculty and staff? Here's my interview with Dr. Brian Strom, Chancellor of Biomedical and Health Sciences and Vice President of Health Affairs at Rutgers University.
Sir, thanks so much for spending some time with us today. I want to start with Rutgers vaccination policy because it has been reported on across the country. As a baseline for discussion, can you just tell us what the vaccination policy is?
Sure. So Rutgers now requires vaccination of all of our students. Takes effect for when the students come after August 1. There are, of course, exemptions for medical or religious exemptions, but beyond that, students will all be required. And as of last week, we put in place a new requirement for healthcare workers. So people who are may be exposed to patients, healthcare workers or security force who the subset of the security force that again may be exposed to patients.
Why did you create exemptions for some of the staff? Why isn't faculty required if the students are?
Yeah, well, right now we are strongly encouraging for our faculty and staff as well. That is absolutely something that we want. Students are higher risk. What we have found during the course of the whole pandemic is Rutgers has been an island of health in a sea of disease. In terms of, we've done much better than the rest of the state has done. But despite that, even within Rutgers, students are higher risk. It's no surprise, they socialize, they go out and do other things. We've been much more aggressive in testing students. They live communally, even when they're not in the dorms, they live in apartments. So students are at higher risk. We want to return the campus to normal. We want the fall to look like pretty close to what Rutgers has always looked like before. That wasn't going to happen without having the students all vaccinated, so people know they can be comfortable with their peers. The student response has been enormously positive. Of course, there's some people who have objected. There were demonstrations once, largely by people who weren't from Rutgers, ironically. But mostly it's been extremely positive. But we need to allow exemptions in terms of medical exemptions and religious exemptions.
I understand those exemptions. I can see why some students would wonder why faculty and staff was, I understand that you say that there's a higher risk with the students. I get that. But It is odd, isn't it, that you don't force it on faculty and staff when you tell the students they have to?
We at least have not forced it, to be clear, on faculty and staff, at least yet. Students were higher priority. Students needed to know first because they needed to decide which colleges to come to.
I see.
The other difference is you know, students can go to different universities. The faculty and staff are employed by us. So it's a different situation. But again, we very, very strongly urge our faculty and staff to get vaccinated. Our hope is that essentially all of them will be.
And you did this, you were the first university in the country to do this. Others followed suit on this. I would imagine that took a lot of discussions and looking through the legality of it and making certain you were doing the right thing. Talk about that process to get to there and if there's been discussion since, if you're still comfortable with it since.
Yeah. So yes, there were a lot of discussions. Ironically, we didn't know we were the first. That didn't affect us. Certainly, there were discussions internally, a lot of discussions about is it the right thing to do. It was clear it was the right thing to do. Public health point of view. From a legal point of view, our reaction was, look, we're going to be sued either way. We might as well be sued for doing the right thing. And you know, our job is to protect our students and to protect our staff. And that was our priority. And have discussions continued since? Sure. Now there are over 500 universities by last count that are doing the same, requiring it of either students or faculty and staff or both. We are reassured that we did the right thing. Discussions have continued in terms of healthcare workers, leading to the requirement last week, and discussions continue in terms of faculty and staff. You know, part of the question is how many are doing it on their own, and what can we do to increase that number if we're doing it on their own?
Will you have vaccinations available to be given on the university campus?
Yes, they are available. They on all three of our campuses, you can get vaccinated, we have at this point twice as many slots as that is twice as many open slots. So we have plenty of vaccine. And atypically compared to most places, we actually give people choices. We have both at each of the three sites. We have both the J&J vaccine and one of the mRNA vaccines available. So people can choose either one. They can decide to get the mRNA vaccine, which means a second dose also, or they can choose the one dose vaccine.
I know it's been controversial across the country to force healthcare workers to get vaccines. 130 healthcare workers walked out of a hospital, Houston Methodist Hospital, because of that. Was there any controversy with your decision?
Well, certainly we were careful in our discussions and thinking about it closely. It's in some ways less controversial than you would think. Certainly there are many healthcare systems across the country already doing that. University of Pennsylvania is one of them, and they're in Princeton. So even throughout New Jersey, there's already requirements for everybody. Our RWJ Barnabas Health, our clinical partners, have required it of management and are planning to expand it. University Hospital in Newark has required it of all of their staff. You know, our goal as healthcare professionals is to protect our patients. And we would prefer everybody get it and everybody get it voluntarily. But our first and from a professional point of view, our obligation is to our patients. We have to proceed.
It is wonderful. It sounds like that's all you thought of. With the legality, with people of controversy, with protest, it seems like your only mandate was to try to keep people safe, and you did the best thing you possibly could do. Is this a moving target for you, though? Could you change? Could you evolve depending on where we go as a country or where we go as a state with this virus?
Oh, I think this virus is very much a moving target, and part of what made this more pressing now is the Delta variant. You know, we will probably have a surge in 3 weeks because the Delta variant. July 4th combined with the Delta variant together, hopefully a very small surge. I mean, we will hopefully never be back where we were in the past. But our goal is to keep people healthy. And our primary goal as healthcare workers is to keep our patients healthy. So might this change? Of course it might change as the pandemic changes. But if it changes, it'll likely to be stricter, not to be less strict, because the pandemic's not going away. We need to learn to coexist with this. It's not going to disappear.
Are there any other restrictions from coming back to school? Do people have the option to be virtual? Masks, are they required? Are they mandatory or voluntary?
Masks are mandatory for those who are not vaccinated. They are voluntary for other people. We don't want our non-vaccinated people even on campus. So yes, there are restrictions in terms of students who aren't vaccinated are not allowed on campus for anything.
Virtual option?
Yes, they have exemptions. And if they have exemptions, they can do it wearing masks.
But is there a virtual option, or are they just out of school?
It depends on the class. There will be some classes that will have virtual options. There are others that won't. It is not likely they will be able to they certainly won't have the same experience. And from a clinical point of view, in terms of my part of the university, the clinical schools, there are schools like public health that certainly can go virtual, but there are plenty, most of my schools have clinical rotations, and the clinical sites will probably be requiring vaccination. And so the students won't be able to graduate if they're not vaccinated. And we'll do everything possible to help them, but we cannot guarantee graduation if they're not vaccinated.
Sarah, thank you so much for your time.
Dr. Brian Strom, Chancellor of Biomedical and Health Sciences at Rutgers University. Still to come on Jersey Matters, the state is finally going to get the lead out of water pipes up and down the state, but it's going to be expensive. We'll tell you how much next.